Information Quebec is current startup approved, clear to pivot via VAVOR 1 Sierra Departure, runway 2 weeks left, flight plan route squawk 2301.
Just event
Mangrove 012, read back correct, call me for push.
Operation
4439er, taxi 2, entry 8, via Oscar 2.
Croatian
4439. Croatian 4439 to entry Sierra 8 and hold short there.
Entry Sierra, hold short of the
Croatian 4439. Mention apron, guten Morgen, LTU 72, direction 7022 at 117, request IFR clearance to Quebec to seabase with info Quebec.
Good morning, everyone.
LTU 7022.
No,
what? Apron, good morning.
Let's get my seat set and then I have to change tank.
Startup approved. Clear to TBAT via VAVOR 1 Sierra Departure, runway 26 left. Flight plan route, squawk 2307.
LTU 7022. TVAT via the VAVOR 1-0 departure route, squawk 2307. Flight plan route.
LTU 7022, read back correct, call me for push.
LTU 7022
is ready
for 01.
Two stations, please, one after the other.
We'll see 9901, they're requesting clearance, we need information today.
Velocity 9901, is this correct?
Affirm, velocity 9901.
Velocity 9901, hold standby, call you back for clearance. Some other, so, Giant 4147, München apron, good morning and welcome. Taxi 2 gate 101. Disregard, you are too big. Giant 1471, taxi 2, gate 105. We are Charlie 1, Oscar 1.
Ground velocity 1 on Sierra 4.
Taxi to gate 105 by Charlie 101, John 371, thank you and good morning to you.
LTU 7022, ready for push.
LTU 7022, pushback approved, facing south.
Push approved, facing south, LTU 7022.
Would you ground? Good morning, Steve. Thompson 1 Victor Bravo with Quebec 1009. 1037 clearance, Quebec, please.
Thompson 1 Victor Bravo, München Apron, good morning. Stand by for clearance number 2.
And hello.
I've filed the plan, you've got your flight plan there.
Doing everything?
That's alright, I've taken 22 tonnes, which is what the flight plan says. I don't think we're going to need
morning. Taxi to stand 15.
It's gone home.
4. Via Whiskey 1.
15 Whiskey 1, I love
it. So we're going to Tivat. This is going to be fun. Dave is meant to be social second, so I guess he'll be here shortly.
Yep. Right. Let's do this. Are we number 22?
Yeah, we are. I've already done it.
Oh, you've done.
I've done. I've done. I haven't done all the rest. Now I've just done literally. But we've got a duplication on the flight board. 1622 is not just this flight, but it's the next one as well.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Oops.
Yeah, that matter.
Destination is LYTB.
Velocity 91.04 pushback approved, facing south.
847 Charlie.
Pushback approved, facing south.
Departure arrival. Just before you finish that, can you just quickly get me the weather?
Croatian 4439, I contact München Tower 118, Desimus 7, have a nice flight, bye bye.
Met an 8-2, please.
187, thank you, Croatian.
Thanks, sweetie.
Munich ground, Leavitt 4320, request back.
Sorry if I pong a little bit.
That's right, we're never stupid. I can't tell you.
Taxi 2 entry November 2 via Oscar 1 Charlie 1.
I think that's a wild Dave coming.
Yep.
Good morning!
Hello, Dave!
Ah, Dave is here. Jesus Christ.
Velocity 1, München apron, good morning, welcome.
Welcome, that's got to be Flo.
Welcome in.
Taxi 2, gate 104, via Whiskey 1, Charlie 3, Oscar 1.
Gate 104 via Whiskey 1, Charlie 3 and Oscar 1. Thank you very much, Graham. Velocity 1.
Very good, 12 at Apron 1, ready to taxi.
Last station call time again.
Two more.
Yeah, it's early, mate. I woke up at 2:30.
Oh, sorry for that.
Mental, innit? I'm a flying a pretend plane.
There is an Airbus on Oscar 1, please stand by.
UDAAVE.
LTU 7022, request entry.
LTU 7022, taxi 2, entry Sierra 6, via Oscar 1, Charlie 4.
Taxi entry Sierra 6 via Oscar 1, Charlie 4, LTU 7022.
We know what runway you're on.
26 left. Pretty sure.
Got the wind and temperature there.
Yeah, there you go. Now let me just check the information.
Request push, we'll receive Quebec.
Quebec.
Yeah, I'm a German speaker, I'm not a native speaker, please let me slow.
Apologies, velocity 25, gate.
Is it flow on ground? Can you check?
Request push.
Oh no.
On my frequency. Velocity 25.
Do you mind if I can put the AP on, just to see if we've got some...
I don't doing, so stand by. I'm sure on my piece of paper. Ah, okay, velocity 25. Push back approved, facing south.
Push approved, facing south, velocity 25. Thank you.
Grunt.
Mention Good morning, Spirit 47, Charlie 747-400 on 108 apparently. We have information, Quebec QNH 1009. Clearance please, Tibet.
Last station, only call sign again.
Speedbird 47, Charlie.
Speedbird 47, Charlie. Stand by for clearance number 3.
And EDTR 975 also requests clearance.
Okay, good. So we've got air conditioning at least now. I don't know why it didn't work off the condition.
Yeah, I don't know.
Speedbird 4320, contact München Tower, 1-1-7, nice flight, bye bye.
Oh, you'll do it.
Who are you up to?
Do that, sorry.
G'day, Connors 25 with your request clear.
We'll do critical data in a minute, yeah? Once just got the clearance to confirm that we've got the right departure and everything.
25, is it correct?
53 now?
Yep.
Qantas
25.
You know what departure is, yeah?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's the Vavos 1 Sierra or the Vavos 1 Whiskey. I'm not quite sure which what the difference is between the two, to be honest.
Okay.
There's
the performance stuff.
Thank you.
Thank you
so much. Can you say again, last there's some donuts out there. If you need, I had a donut.
Did you?
Yeah, I was like,
nice.
I'm still going to make Corgi buy me a fresh one, though.
Okay, it was D90104. Sorry for that, and I apologize, but you have more than 20 pilots on the frequency, and I'm not a native speaker. Velocity 90104, please taxi to entry Sierra 8 via Whiskey 2 Delta 4.
Second.
He says he's not a native speaker, but
he's doing very well.
Bad.
Very good job, yeah.
Yeah.
Better than our German. Okay, do you want to do the critical data then while we're waiting for that?
Yep.
So, according to the flight plan, zero fuel weight is 223.3.
223.3? 3? Okay.
Yep. Yep, seen that.
Then
thrust limb. So, takeoff weight should be 245. If we look at the gross weight, we should be just a touch above that, I guess. Yeah, 300 kilos.
Yep.
So, I would like temp 59. Hopefully that'll give us either climb 2, climb 1. I would like climb 1.
Climb 1.
Thank you.
Mango,
flaps 20.
Yep. It's 1,000.
Taxi
yep.
2.
And 1,000 for the engine out.
Entry Sierra 6.
And as it's going to be, what, 625 in the morning, I guess 1,000 for flat thrust reduction as well.
Okay,
V1 is 129. Same for VR. 146 V2. And the Mac Tau is 19. Just want to cross check that I've done that all correctly.
Velocity 99901. Are you ready to copy?
Yep. Okay. Thank you very much.
Go ahead, Velocity 99901.
So, I don't know if you want me to tell you the charts to bring up on your side.
Cleared. Information Romeo is current. Startup approved. Cleared to T-Bud via Vavo 1.
Who's upstairs?
Flight plan score 2303.
Terminal 108.
Yeah, 108. Yeah, that's what it says on that gate, so I presume that's where we are.
That Rebel
1
Sierra departure, Jesus West, squawk 2-3.
Battery 3-4, we're flying to Tibet. It's on the coast.
Down
towards the Croatia area.
So, which chart are you looking at, sorry?
Okay, so I have the following up. I have 3-20. Actually, I'll give you one at a time if you want. So, 3-30 first, sorry. If you want that one. Actually, disregard, sorry, I got the wrong.
Thompson,
I presume my APC West then, are we?
Are you ready to copy a clear?
We
sorry.
Are...
APC West, are we? So we need 3-40 first.
Thompson 1, Victor Bravo.
Yep.
Okay, so I know technically the briefing should say we do threats first, but I think we'll go through the charts first and then we'll talk about threats if you're happy.
Okay.
Okay, cool. So they put us on 108. We're expecting 26 left.
Yep.
So we can expect push face south, presumably onto yellow because we're wide-winged,
yep.
As opposed to orange. Taxi out via Sierra 6 and then either Sierra Tango, probably Tango to the end of runway 26 left.
Yep.
We will go, we can take 13, 14, 15, whichever they give us, because it all ends up on the same point. If you want to have a quick look at 3-20, you'll see what I mean.
Thompson 1, Victor Bravo, read back correct, call me for push.
So if you look at the end, you see 13, 14 and 15 all go on at the same point, so
yeah,
so we don't have to make any specific requirement for that. It is cold, it's 1 degree. And it was raining earlier, I don't know if that's now stopped.
So, we might need to use the anti-ice?
I think 100% we'll need to use anti-ice, yeah, because it's also 6,000 meters visibility, so there's definitely moisture in the air, so anti-ice will be required.
Yep.
No de-icing required, though, so we should be all good running on the ground for, what, 15 minutes? Okay, departure-wise, if you want to look at 4-60,
Yep.
We are departing on the Vavor 1 Sierra. Oh, well, at the moment, that's what we're doing.
Yep.
Which is off 26 left. You climb ahead, but we, rather than do the whiskey, we do a left turn. And at, sorry, Delta Mike 049 at max 210 knots is the note there. Left turn. Oh no, sorry, that might only be for the Abaxas departure, so we can disregard that. But we make a left turn to Delta Mike 050. Further left again, inbound to Munich, which we leave on a radial 127 to Lackau, and then to Vavor. And then we join the airway. We don't do that Yankee 106 to Tobad.
Okay, the speed restriction of 210 applies to all sitters as well. It's not just the Abaxa 4 Sierra, so...
Right, okay,
at,
yeah.
At DM 050, there's max speed of 210.
And we have that in the box. So we've got that 210 in the box, so
okay.
Hopefully we should be good with that.
Yep.
Okay, delivery's online. Can you just check that frequency for me, Dave?
Velocity 25.
121.72.
There's a velocity. Jupiter 975 with information Romeo and 214 request clearance.
Okay, so yeah, I've just looked at chart 5-130 just for the.
Delivery, good morning, number 2, Hollyback. And New Zealand 115, you read back, please.
And that, I'll go through the box shortly. You know, dig yourself in the head. Nice.
New Zealand 115, speed back correct. Then ready for pushback, contact 8-1-1-7.
And to get the queue, speed at 47 Charlie, stand 108 with Romeo, but just to get in the queue for clearance, please.
Speedbird 47 Charlie, number 2 for clearance, call you back.
Check.
Break, Egypt Air, Niner.
Okay, so Vavor 1 Sierra departure. I don't know if you just want to read that out, what the FMS says. In that bottom bit. So on that bottom bit of the FMS, just read out what it says. Should say 1900 first, A1900 plus.
Sorry, where am I?
So right at the bottom of that Vavor 1 Sierra, it should say FMS. And
oh, yeah. Yep.
Yep.
So it says 1900 or above,
yep.
At DM049.
Okay, so that should be a separate point. So it would be 1900, then
right.
DM049.
Yep. And then DM050.
Yep.
Max speed of 210.
Got it.
Munich.
Yep.
Speed 250 or below.
Correct.
and Lacol.
Yep.
And then Vavor.
All correct.
Quick.
Now he's going to give us the one whiskey and just totally mess everything up.
Yeah.
Information Romeo, you're cleared to T-Bus via Vavor 1-0 departure. I've turned route for 2-3-1-2-0.
Okay, Speedwood 47 Charlie cleared to VAT, startup is approved via the Vavor 1 Sierra departure, runway 23 left, and squawk is 2312. Get that? Munich, Speedwood 47 Charlie.
Gone. He's gone.
So he's disappeared.
Yeah, he's gone offline. He's giving you clearance, so basically just call ground for you.
Okay, do you want to do... okay, so let's just complete the brief. So that's all the chart information.
Yep.
So, if I can have a quick look at this. Threats out of Munich, any that you've thought of straight away? I imagine there's one that's going to be quite obvious. What can we hear in our ears?
Digging?
What can we hear in our ears?
Germans.
Germans being one, but I was going to say lots of traffic.
Oh, right, okay.
So, yeah, Germans. Yeah, well, they might invade. That is a concern. Yes, Germans and more importantly traffic here being the big problem. But, and obviously ATC having a nightmare, but other than that, Munich's pretty good. Nice long runway, we're very light. The only thing I would say is if you see the climb rate being ultra excessive, just give me a shout because we're going to be exceptionally light on the takeoff.
Yep.
MEL, the items we're aware of is the isolation valve stuck on and center autopilot won't display a light, but in the event of a Cat 3 it will be active. Any others?
We said about the icing as well, didn't we? Not the MEL items, but the sort of the thready stuff.
Yeah, absolutely.
Deal with the icing, so...
Yep, that's fine. So AIS is the charts. The database is up to date. The charts we've already gone through, which I'm happy with that we know what we're doing. Weather, as I've gone through, visibility is okay at the moment, 6,000 metres, potentially going down to 3,000 a little bit later on. The guys, when I landed, had pretty good visibility, so I don't see that being a problem. Just as we said, anti-ice going on after start. And obviously your sleepiness is a threat, I imagine, as well. If you can monitor that as socials. I'm gonna turn around, I think, in the cruise, and you're to just be like... Okay, takeoff alternate. In the event we need to come back, we will come back to here. I doubt it will happen, but in the event we do, we will. Nice long runway here, and, you know, hopefully we won't have to. Taxi route we've discussed, we're going to go south, push south, and then wiggle our way around to the end of the runway 26 left.
Nice and easy.
Flap, standard thrust 20, nothing to discuss there, runway's nice and long, we've discussed, and we've got a hefty D rate. And as I said, the one thing I'd ask you to do is just monitor the climb rate as we're going out. We've got the 7,000 restriction, and more importantly, probably the speed for that left turn. Terrain awareness. Munich has got some terrain around, but it's more to the west and a little bit to the south, but it's predominantly to the west, I think. If we widen out the terrain, 1700 within 20 miles, so it's pretty flat in the immediate vicinity. MSA sector safe, according to the chart, is 3700, but as you say, to the south, particularly the southeast. Goes up to 11,000. So in the event of a problem, we'd love to ask to go probably north, where it's a little bit flatter. Transition altitude on the chart is 5,000, so we've got that in there. It's all done. SID we've discussed, it's the RNAV, so we have everything pretty much in the box for us. AFDS, I can never remember what that is. Let's skip it. Radio aids, we'll just let it auto-tune. The only VOR on the departure is Munich, which is already preset on the left side, so that's all good. FMC is complete. We've got all the data in there, and the progress page gives us a remaining fuel 10.7, and the plan suggested 10.5, so we're spot on for that. Emergencies, do you want to tell me what we're going to stop for? Because I can't, I can never remember the 4th and 5th.
I can remember 4 of them.
Go on, go 4.
So, any fire.
Yep.
Engine failure with 2 or more parameters.
Yep.
Monitor radar display.
Yep.
Ground velocity 738, holding at entry point 0.5.
Takeoff config warning.
Config warning, yeah.
Wind shear?
Good morning.
Is that part of the...
I think that's monitor radar.
Yeah. So there's one other that we'll decide. If it happens, we'll think that's the other one we've got to stop for, yeah?
Yep.
Other than that, we'll go. We're doing what everyone else seems to be doing. I quite like the idea of I set stable, you take the throttle, set thrust, and then I take over. So,
say that again.
So I'll get the throttle stable, take my hand away.
Yeah.
You'll then set take off thrust to avoid this stuttering issue we have with Toga.
Yeah.
And then once you've got power set, I'll put my hand back on.
Okay.
Any questions?
No.
Question is, what is AFBS?
47 Charlie, stand 1208, request push. Pre-flight when you're ready, please. Oh, I thought I'd got in there. I'll take the APU so you can get rid of the ground power, Dave. Okay, when you're ready.
Inspection security.
Completed.
Oxygen.
Tested 100%.
Flight instruments.
We're heading 081, indicated just a touch under 1500, 1009.
What have I got? Parking brake.
Is set.
Fuel control switches.
Cut off.
BFD.
Okay, so we have V1129, V2 of 147. Toga, LNAV, VNAV, arm 7000 set.
Takeoff speeds.
129, 129, 147.
ACARS pre-flight.
Completed.
CDU pre-flight.
Complete.
Taxi and takeoff briefing.
Complete.
Pre-flight complete.
Qantas 25, I didn't understand you. You are too high on with your speaking.
Can we get that in text, please? In text?
Okay, Qantas 25. Sorry.
Munich, good morning again. Speedbird 47, Charlie, stand 108. When you're ready, push start, please.
Speedbird 47 Charlie, you're the next one, please stand by.
47 Charlie. Okay, good, for the next one apparently.
Yippee!
What head do you want to go to when you...
Sorry?
What direction do you want to go to when you push?
We're going
to
go that way, please.
What about...
South. Right. 180.
Velocity 99901, contact tower 118 doesn't return.
I'm probably going to take weather my side once we heading out to the runway. If you could take terrain, please. As long as you're happy with that. Do you want to do before start now?
Before start, check.
1 second. Ground from flight deck.
Ground.
Hello, sir. Good morning. Are we cleared to pressurise?
Yeah. Ja, gut. Ja, gut, mein Führer.
Jawohl.
Did you like the way there I subtly reminded you to do your flows?
Yeah. Sort of.
Only pushing straight. Yeah, I can't do this because there are too many pilots on the frequency and on the apron. Please stand by.
Oh.
Passenger signs?
Are on.
Beacon?
Is on, or both.
Bonder?
Is set. Off and auto.
Before start checklist complete.
Thank you, Craig. Awesome job. So I've done something a little bit cheeky, and I picked us a different departure to what the world flight routing is. I've taken a different route.
Okay.
Hopefully that means that in the event that there's route congestion, we may get snuck in. But these are the Germans.
Speedbird 47 Charlie, are you ready to copy?
A firm 47 Charlie.
Speedbird 47
Charlie.
Pushback approved, facing south.
Push approved, face south. Speedbird 47 Charlie, thanks. Cockpit to ground, we've been cleared to push. Standing by your brakes. Yes, release brakes. Your goal brakes release, sir, my Führer.
25 contact tower 118 107, bye bye.
87, goodbye.
Should be coming into push. Do I need to set the brakes before he tells me to release the brakes? Yeah, set it again. You can do it a different way. Go into ground services. Close that, sorry. Close.
Set parking brake, please.
Oh, yes, you just asked me to set the parking brake. So if you close that one, though, Dave. No, the close on the right. You see, that's it, and then do the push from there, so push back.
Currently chocked, yeah. Move parking brakes.
This is Sunderk 137, requesting push and stop.
Okay, push back.
Sunderk 137.
Okay, it's saying the aircraft is not. Oh, you've got the chocks on, that's why. Chocks, green light on the right. There.
Oh dear, sorry.
Now push back.
Stevens 1001, ready to copy.
I should be just going to use the degrees I put in there, is it?
Yeah.
Or just.
Come on!
Information Romeo is current, startup approved, cleared to TVAT via VAVO 10 departure, runway 26 left, flight plan route squawk 2314.
Dying system removed and steering pin removed.
Okay, so he's gone through the thing, so. Just try that again now.
Steering pin inserted, release brakes please.
Brakes release, there we go. Thank you, Dave. Okay, Craig. 4321, please. 4 and 3 when you are ready.
Okay, talk.
Stevens 1001, pushback approved, facing south.
That's it, magic just keep this turn that way, I think. We'll be fine.
Unit ground, is it there
9? I've always seen them go that way first and that way. That's a bit of a wiggle.
It's revised, it was nice, it was lovely. You actually managed to avoid the Air New Zealand, really nice. Look at all those. Yeah, look at all those.
Wow.
There's 6 of them in a line. More than that. Right, we've got to catch up the Qantas 2-5.
Courtesy.
Our low startup sounds are such a delight now.
Yeah.
Love that.
If you want to stop us there, that would be about right, and then I can just make the right turn.
Yeah.
It stopped.
415.
Set parking brake, please.
Negative
9 or 75.
Get rid of that?
Yeah, happy for you to get rid of that. 214. Okay, we've got a good start, stable on all three. Stable on 2. My time is kicking in as 2 and 1, please.
Car to land, good morning.
And order start.
EZL 975, pushback approved, face, same
time. N2 rising.
Push approved, face, same time. EZL 975, thank you very much.
Ground, this is Sunderk 137. We already have our route clearance. Requesting push and start.
Start out.
Okay, to cancel?
Yep. And start complete.
Ground velocity 9030, requesting pushback.
Yeah, I'll take him a little bit over, it's fine. Can leave him on.
Again?
You can leave him on, that's fine.
Okay.
Can I just have status flaps recall, please? Just leave the status page for the flight controls. Watch your groin.
Sunderk
East Air 458, stand 216, information Romeo Boeing 77 Whiskey, ready for push and start.
Very good. Stand by on the after start.
The 458.
Don't push him, don't push him. No! Don't push him, tell the engine to stop. 247 Charlie, request taxi. Just if we can go before that Egypt Air, that would be great.
Speedbird 47 Charlie, taxi 2, entry Sierra 6, via Oscar 1, Charlie 4.
Oscar 1, Charlie 4 to Sierra 6, Speedbird 47 Charlie.
Mission ground, Con 6301, Bay 103, request push and
Oscar 1, radio. Charlie 3, Sierra 6, so he's not asking us to go the other way. He asked us to face south. Okay, after start, please. And I might do something a little bit. I might create my own taxiway here.
Yeah, no, it's fine. Flight controls.
I checked.
Anti-ice.
Is now. Yes, that's the right one. Is it on?
Recall, I've done.
Checked.
Order break.
Is set, RTO.
Laps.
I've seen green light, 20.
Ground crew clearance.
Received.
Taxi briefing.
Okay, is there anyone to the right when I swing this round?
Nope. Not that I can see.
Is there anyone right of us?
Nope. Still okay. Clear. Still clear.
Alright.
Still clear.
Let's disregard these jetways and pretend they don't exist.
Very buff.
Ground for City 9030, requesting pushback.
Hapag Lloyd 502, pushback approved, facing south.
Alright, this isn't all that realistic, guys, please bear with us.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
Okay,
wipe out that jetway, it's
fine. Alright, let's avoid this Thompson and Suntec that are taxing into each other.
Maybe we're heading to another runway.
Ground for City 9030, requesting pushback.
Yes, we beat the one Victor Bravo. Don't push into him though.
Couple having a French conversation. I've obviously no idea what they're saying.
Nice.
Speedbird 47 Charlie, you are. What are you on texting? So, don't be in a hurry.
Okay.
Okay.
Where's he wanted to go? Where's he wanted to go?
Sierra 6, which is that one there. So I'm going to follow the New Zealand.
Ground, this is, Sundeck 137.
That's sun coming through the clouds.
Sorry?
Is that lights coming through the cloud?
No, I think it's the floodlights, yeah, it's a floodlight effect.
Sundeck 137. Hold position,
I think he said hold Sierra 6, didn't he?
Speedbird 47 Charlie on Sierra 6, contact tower 118 decimal 7, bye bye.
Just say apologies for our creative taxiing.
118 decimal 7, my apologies for the creative taxiing, Speedbird 47 Charlie.
You spelled Brad first.
Velocity 9030, requesting taxi.
Where to pass through decoration. Why do we take this too?
Take it.
Well, besides it just says, why do they take this too realistic and simulated take off? I think the fact that we just actually
tower speed 47 Charlie holding short Sierra 6.
Sorry, Dave.
That's right.
Speed 47 Charlie.
Why do you apologise?
Logan, taxi to holding point runway 26 left via right. Bravo 14.
Bravo 14 to hold short 26 left.
Just confirm via Sierra Tango.
Just confirm via Sierra Tango, Speedbird 47 Charlie.
And negative, it's Bravo 14 via Sierra.
Yep.
Bravo 14 via Sierra, Speedbird 47 Charlie.
That makes sense, first left. And then, as we said, Bravo 14 is one of those ones at the end. I think it's the middle one. It is.
Yep.
Actually, what he wanted to do then was to come out, go literally round.
Yeah, he wanted to go round the big circle, yeah, but he pushed us the wrong way.
That's right, we could have just turned around and done that one.
Or, make a creative tax actually.
Yeah.
What's the difference between what the two seems the two weather radars on each pilot screen? One is a weather radar, which is on the left hand side, so
I think that
Dave has got the weather
there.
Radar on.
Yeah.
Crag, he's got the terrain radar, so that's why it's all brown on that side. But each pilot has their own, and they choose depending on what the one of the threats may be. So what's the biggest threat? So if the weather's going to be the biggest threat for this departure, then the pilot flying will actually put the weather on, so that way he can actually look at that and avoid it if necessary. And the terrain will be on the other one for a situation awareness.
So have you thought of anything else that we need to be worried of, Craig, or...?
No, apart from sleep deprivation.
Yep, and my creative taxiing. Other than that, we should be good.
Yeah.
That's just going to be really confusing. They're saying, Dave, what are you doing up at this time? I'm not quite sure which Dave you're on about. I'm up because I'm the social secretary.
I'm up because Dave, I'm pilot flying. 5.5.
Joys of world flight and some creative rostering.
Benny rostering, I think.
It's about, well, I'm doing too bad, actually.
Yeah, honestly, on Monday night, I put my head down about probably about 10:20, and I was out like that.
Yeah,
just went. Didn't stand a chance.
He's actually been up since 2:00, so. How are we all this morning?
Okay, before takeoff checklist, please.
We're good.
Before takeoff checklist.
We did get cam ready, I put it in there for you.
Okay, final load sheet. Is there?
Can you acknowledge it for me?
I can't remember.
Go to ACARS, just clear that CCC out. Flight init.
Yeah.
And it is. I cannot remember.
I think it's message.
Ah, yes, sorry, no, you are right, it is message. Stored up links, perhaps?
Unit Tower, good evening, Seabrook 3. Fully established ILS 2.
Yeah, I did delete some of those.
Clients.
Next
page.
See,
I didn't get the acknowledge page either when I looked at it. Maybe go to the end.
Poseidon loves you.
Poseidon loves me?
Yeah.
Nice. Let's just say,
acknowledged. He's a bit busy taxiing at the moment, so he's Tucker.
Cliff takeoff, runway 26 left, speedbird 47 Charlie. Okay, flaps.
20 green light.
Trim.
Set 5.5 units.
Takeoff briefing
is completed.
Runway speed Zebra and Vina.
Set.
Cabin report
received.
And transponder.
As it should be.
Okay.
Thank you.
You are now lit up like a Christmas tree.
Wonderbar. Traffic 26 left. Nothing on approach from what I can see.
Okay.
And confirm cliff takeoff.
Yep.
Okay, so again, I'll stabilise power.
Yep.
And then you take it for set the thrust, and then we'll launch into the sky, hopefully.
What are these lights again that Gary's put on for the taxi lights?
Oh, what, these? The forward-facing lights?
Yeah.
I don't know who they're made by. I don't know whether they're custom for PSX or...
No, they've changed them the other day. They are custom. I can't remember. There's a company that does all the lights. Or...
The redux lights.
The waypoints on the left are from the leg
before. Okay, take off.
No. All the legs you see is what you got. Poseidon, I'm sure he said he does love you.
Hey, your throttles.
Use the
link 5,
contact
Virginia from 1-1. Thrust set, scene. I have control. Checked.
And we're off.
And
gear up.
Up.
LNAV. No, I'm saying what we've got on the FMA. And thrust right for enough speed.
Speed
123, 90, Speedway 47 Charlie, many thanks.
Flaps 10, please.
10. Departure Speedway 47 Charlie with you, passing through 2900.
Speedbird 47 Charlie, mentioned the radar, good day. I not identified the clock. Charlie, please.
Dave.
Flap 5.
Okay, are we squawking Charlie now, Speedbird 47 Charlie?
No, you were, but
just here, I did.
Speedbird 47 Charlie, now identified. Climb flight level 150.
I'm in flight level 150, speed with 47 Charlie.
Flap 1.
Gen X 5, Juliet Lima, descent altitude 4000 feet, QNH 100 meter.
Okay, we're now clear 250, so I'll accelerate.
Okay.
And set standard.
Standard.
And I'm passing. If it will let me click the bloody standard.
Do it either.
There we go. Passing 6-2 now.
Yep.
And flaps up.
Flap up.
That was very easy.
Yep.
Considering how busy ground was, they didn't have many aircraft at the end, did they?
No.
Okay, passing 100.
Okay.
No.
Not strobes.
What we're doing.
Okay, passing through 108 now.
Pass.
I'm into flight level 150, standard set and costume.
Passing 113 now.
Deciding that.
Got the answer to takeoff checklist.
Yes, please.
After takeoff checklist, landing gear
is off.
Flaps
up.
Air conditioning and pressurization. 135.25 Speedbird 47 Charlie.
And the air conditioning pressurization is checked, and it's all good.
Meters.
Standard set and cross checked.
After takeoff checklist complete.
Thank you, Craig.
Munich Speedway 47 Charlie with you, passing through flight level 140 for flight level 150.
Speedway 47 Charlie, you're in control.
Flight level 370, Speedway 47 Charlie.
Okay, we cleared 370.
Roger, we'll speed with 4320,
Venus speed thrust ref.
Force is just to your tail clock, about 650 miles per liter there.
As it's my last flight, I thought I might as well fly it for a bit.
Yep, why not?
It's not, it's so he can actually flex his muscles on his arms.
Yeah.
Put some nice cloud formations.
Yeah, looks good. And now we're above the cloud, we can lose that anti-ice, I think, Greg.
Poseidon, the question you said is, if someone is Microsoft Flight Simulator expert,
Would that someone be able to fly a simulator of these, or is it really different? I'm assuming it means, if you fly it like this 747, can you fly this aircraft for real? I think the system-wise are identical, so you'll be able to do everything in the cockpit. However, Peter, our resident real aircraft pilot, assumes that the hardest part actually is landing, and he says that's where you wouldn't be able to do. So when everybody says, could you land the aircraft, very much doubt it, because you don't have the sense of depth and the feel, and you've never sort of flown a real 747 into landing. So don't volunteer if they says, can anybody fly an aircraft.
Okay, did you science here?
Absolutely. And 20 checks.
Yep, 20 checks please.
What?
Just want to check the pressurization's good.
Yeah.
20 checks is you are passing flight level 200, coming up to flight level 370.
Down to set, cross check. As Dave said. What am I doing?
Who knows?
You can just clear the ECS, press ECS, and then that lower arc has disappeared. Wonderful.
I'm glad you're here, Dave.
Now, the second one at 20 is just basically confirming that you have got the displays, it's still on standard. That's all. Then you do the next one, which is at 1,000.
I was listening to you educating Gunny yesterday, Dave. You did a very good job. It's quite painful at one point. But Gunny picked it up nice and quick. You trying to explain Toga to him was...
Yeah,
that was painful to watch. I knew exactly what you meant as soon as you said it, but he was like, what the hell are you talking about?
I'm assuming he hasn't seen it in here, sort of thing, so... Oh, blame.
So be RVSM compliant, I'm going to take left command.
The total? We've done pretty well, Kev. The last night flight, I was at one point speechless. I couldn't actually say anything, so...
So, good morning, everyone. Apologies that I haven't really been engagement chat at all with pilot flying. I wanted to get out ASAP because we were actually about half an hour behind schedule, so as I was here nice and early, I wanted to try and get us back on schedule as we were. We left about 8 minutes ago, so we were probably 25 minutes after push time, so hopefully that means we should land into that pretty much about right at 7 o'clock, I think we're estimated, so 7:06 isn't bad.
I didn't actually change the cameras then, but I'll change one away in, so a little better.
Doesn't matter, I think the way in's going to be the more interesting one to that. It's quite a challenging approach. Do you want to just update the compliance? No? I'll do it then.
There we go. Let's see if we can do it like Luke.
That is just so painful. It was. Kids these days, eh?
Poseidon says, imagine having one of these simulators in your home. We do.
Yeah, we're lucky enough that we do, yeah.
We are very fortunate. How was your trip yesterday, Kev? Actually, it's 6 o'clock, so it's 10 o'clock at night. Vegas is 7 hours behind, isn't it? Need to delete some of those messages, actually.
Just looking at this acknowledgement.
Where do I put it?
Zero fuel weight, you just update it. It may have changed.
Usually does by a kilogram or so.
Done.
Thanks, Tim.
I think the acknowledgement doesn't... If he goes over so many pages, you don't actually get it sometimes.
Wake me up, where we land?
Walco.
Yes, to the sim.
You've been blamed 130 times, apparently.
How many times has Benny been blamed?
Don't know, should we see?
Yep.
He overtook at one point.
Did.
Wonder if he's still chatting up Christine.
Probably.
He's not here, is he?
Sorry?
Not here.
Yeah, he's not here.
No, he's gone because he's actually not here today, is he? So I don't think. Or he's going to bed. He hasn't been in bed.
127 times.
Oh, crap.
Very close.
Failing.
Very close. Romantic way to wake up. Look at that, we can set the ambiance.
I know,
no, you can't
couldn't
do that.
Imagine
you can't
spending
see the
it when, with anyone but you, Dave.
Thanks, Greg. Appreciate that.
Apart from Valentina.
Yeah, she actually said last night, she said, oh, when you were flying, I'm sure I heard Craig say he loves me. I said, yes, that's probably true. Probably did, yeah.
Oh, Poseidon. Is he in love with you again?
Is he, Poseidon? Hello, Poseidon.
You're good for water, etc.
Could I have a water, please, Dave?
Waters.
Yeah, I think that's a fresh one.
Oh, can I have the crisps there, please, Dave?
Breakfast.
Oh.
I brought a club because I didn't know the donuts were outside. I went to look for my one to go. I went to look for my banana that I left, my bananas that I left in the house when I left. They've gone, presumed consumed. So I took a club, and then I found the donuts, and I was
you
like,
you upgraded to the donuts.
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
See, I had the very best of intentions.
Were these yours then?
No. I bought the club.
Like,
No, I'm fine, thank you. All one. Would you like a single crisp? Okay, so I'm hoping once we reach top of climb, we are going to accelerate because I don't quite know why we're going.
Well, you did put a cost in.
53, yeah, but that should give us a speed of about
2.84. Okay.
Let's just have a look, see what 90 gives us.
.135.8 speed of 47 Charlie, thank you very much.
And you have it.
No, thanks for my 2.5 from our levels.
Zero control, speed of 47 Charlie with you, flight 370.
And can we request 390?
47 Charlie Heavy, Zero Radar, warning identified.
And speed of 47 Charlie requesting flight level 390.
47 Charlie, climb flight level 390.
Climb in flight level 390, speed of 40 Charlie. Thank you.
390 set. Yeah, the reason why, Optum 396.
We're off of the 25, requesting flight level 370 if available. Five, yeah, Roger, climb flight level 370.
Yeah, I'm good, thank you mate, thank you very much. So, how crazy was it here when the donations were coming through?
Very, very crazy.
I
was absolutely astonished.
I don't think even in our wildest expectations we thought we'd be... Well, I didn't think at this point we thought we'd be past 10,000, did we? We thought we'd probably be approaching it, hopefully.
Yeah.
To be over 20,000 now.
Yep. It is very, very good.
So thank you everybody that was kind enough to donate. I know one individual donated heavily, and he's a regular viewer of my stream, so thank you so much to Chaos Dispenser. I probably imagine he's asleep right now because I think he's in the States, but thank you so much to Chaos Dispenser for that. Unbelievable generosity. That's when it's gone to record on the stream when I'm at the sim, that I am eternally grateful for that. We've got lots of giveaways, haven't we? Did the CDU go last night?
I think it did, yeah. Not sure. I was asleep.
Nice. How busy was Gatwick this morning? Yeah?
People, telling people to enter the hold. Okay, I didn't give the hold instructions, like it's a left turn and all of that, but it's chart stuff.
Yeah.
They're all like turning the wrong direction, God knows what.
Where were they via Willow mainly?
Yeah.
Because that's a pain in the arse, because they have to go Holly then Willow, don't they? And then they normally overshoot Willow and have to try and get back to it.
Yep.
So, let's have a look and see how I did getting us back on schedule. Where are we in the queue of traffic? I think the Qantas 25 is the aircraft ahead.
Hi Kev, no, I haven't done the dance yet, but we are doing a dual stream with another streamer tonight, so it'll probably be on that stream, if that's okay.
Who might that be you're streaming with?
Who do you think?
So the Qantas 25 is ahead of us.
Uni Chaos, did someone end up in the hot tub? I think Pete is going to end up in the hot tub. Mungo says you look really pretty today, Dave.
I try. Thank you, Mungo. How are you, mate? Hope you're well. So you know that Egypt Air, that is four aircraft behind us, so I did the right thing, I think. And the Thompson 1 Victor Bravo has literally just taken off. So if any of you are wondering, is this cool? Yes, it absolutely freaking is. To be flying a 747 as close to real as it gets, it's a pretty awesome experience, I have to say. Sitting next to Craig is possibly an even better experience for me, personally.
Oh, thanks, mate.
So can I trust you to keep an eye on the charts, and the chat while I look at the charts?
If that's a shame, you probably have to watch it on catch up or something. Unless you're around tomorrow evening. So Thursday evening we're also doing another stream as well. Test flight 357.
Hey, they've given us, it says runway 32. However, for the fact that the more entertaining runway to use is runway 14, I suggest we request it 14. And as we're actually nicely separated between the behind the traffic in front, we may get it. And it's 3 hours before the departure time of the next flight. I'm hoping there's not going to be too many departures. So hopefully they can accommodate
us. Why is it entertaining on 14?
Because it's an NDB 14, and then it's all hand flown on a circling approach for runway 14.
Okay.
I can give you all the chart numbers if you want to get them up.
Not yet.
Okay, so let me program in an arrival, and then we'll have a top of descent, hopefully.
Oh, sorry, Kev, I didn't realise that you were with us on Friday. We'll have to wait till then. Okay guys, I'm just going to have a quick look at the charts and stuff, so I'm just going to head away from the chat. So, be right back. Where are we going?
Tivat. Tivat. Have stars. But we can fly. Departure arrival.
So I'm guessing that we're coming in from Podgors.
Taz is our final point.
Yeah. But that's not on the RNAV though, is it?
No, we're not going to do the RNAV, I think we're going to do Tango Alpha Zulu 2 Alpha. So, we want our route to Tango...
An interesting approach, isn't it?
Yeah. So, pod radial 228.
Okay,
so then Tango India Victor 270.
over.
Actually, 255 over 3.
Do you get an ATIS for Tibet?
Yep, got it here, mate. Okay, I'll have to go through this.
Okay.
Because it's a little bit unclear, but leave that one with me. If we go to route 2. So, guys, let's just have a look at the chat. Hi, Tyler, how's it going? Nice one, go enjoy your sleep. You're with us Friday morning, good news Kev, look forward to seeing you mate. Okay, this is a previous, so let's go route 1. Route copy.
Oh, sorry Luke Nivers, 1983.
Route copy.
I don't know if I can give you permission to that. 1 second.
Two. There. Departure arrival. The legs. How you change the departure arrival from route 1 to route 2? Yeah, so I've done that. So I go to route 2 and departure arrival stays back to route 1. It's the active. So route 1. So now if I do it, am I doing stuff on route 2 or will I clear everything I've done on route 1? So what? So you see route 1 is up here, but in legs page I was on route 2.
Okay.
So if I overwrite stuff, will it overwrite stuff completely? I can do a test and see.
Route 2 appears down here, so you get route 1 here, route 2 here. Do it again.
Ah, yes you do, don't you?
Route 2.
That's why you're the most beautiful, most intelligent man I know. Alright, so we can do localizer 3-2 again via the TAS 2 Alpha. And
that's the most
lovely, isn't it, out the window?
Yeah.
By Lasty, I presume.
That's the most anything has ever said anybody has ever said about me. I'm touched.
Just a lovely person, man.
Yeah.
Hopefully, anyway.
There are some flashing lanes on the forward camera. Lanes? What do you mean by lanes?
Ah, it's this one, isn't it? This one's gone buggered again.
Is it?
If that's the forward facing, they're saying.
Let's have a quick look. I'll have a quick look for you guys, one sec.
Okay. Valid. Sorry guys, yeah, we're just trying to fix that forward facing camera. This one is proving an issue. The issue is it gets very warm and then causes problems for us. Who's talking on the SimFest UK? Is that Dave outside? Or is that Gary on there? Huh? Why is Gary not asleep? Okay, you have control. You have radios because I need a quick jimmy.
Okay, everybody, you have the pleasure of speaking to me for a bit. So then, dum-de-dum, dum-de-dum. Ah, bless. How was Vegas thing, Kev? Or how is Vegas, if you're still out there? Yeah, Unichaos, I had a quick look at the flashing lines on the forward camera. Unfortunately, there's not a lot that we can do about it because the techie guys have gone to sleep, so they'll be able to hopefully have a look at it once we go. The camera is working. We're just getting some strange lines on it, so we'll just have to put up with it for now and then. When we get on the ground, because I think it's a leg with quite a long turnover time, so we can sort of reboot everything and have a look at the cameras. So we'll do it all then. So Vegas good and Chris's sim was great. Sweet.
Good. A little bit more wake now. I've tidied it up, so I've only got two bags today. It's not too bad. So. I had four bags yesterday morning.
Cranky.
Yeah. 37 minutes. Actually, what was that? 37 minutes. Wow.
About 40 minutes. Yeah.
Quite a quick flight this one. Just a quick one down the coast. Or I should say, straight off of Germany, coast of. Italy, basically in Tivat.
Yep.
I tell you what, that was actually quite nice. I was, yeah. Don't be doing that again.
What's that?
I was. I tell you what, Kev. By the time we get to Sunday, usually, you do require at least 2 days to sleep. There's a sort of a standard crew that sort of stay around the place. So you have the free people, the people flying, non-flying, the social secretary. So at night time, it's probably the least amount of people around. There's usually only three people. So that's why we have three of us. That way we can have some sort of conversation because after we spoke to Craig for about 2 minutes, that's it. His whole experience of life is gone, so he's got nothing else to give you. So basically that's why they put old people like me in, so he's had a little bit of a life experience, and he can keep people talking and bore everybody else to death overnight, so they can at least get some sleep. But come sort of breakfast time, people are either arriving or people are getting up, usually because there's food around, so it's like a bit of vultures really. Seafood, they appear. So there's no food at night time, although there's some donuts out there, which I did have one night.
There is some
time.
Donuts.
Very sneaky donut.
Okay, Craig, are you ready for a brief?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, as we spoke about, threats-wise, Tivat is a challenging airport to land at. It would be probably a Cat C airport.
Mountainous terrain, offset, offset localizer or a visual approach?
Offset localizer if we go runway 3-2, or it's a very challenging visual approach, which I'm more interested in doing for runway 4, I fancy.
Okay.
Pooling my skills.
Okay.
So, what I've done, our first preference is to do the visual 1-4.
Okay.
And hopefully we've timed it well enough that we're far enough behind the Qantas and further enough away from the person behind that we can do that.
Okay.
So we'll ask ATC, presumably when we contact approach, just request that early. Try and stay awake for my brief, I'd appreciate it.
Sorry?
Stay awake for my brief, I'd appreciate it.
I'm sorry.
So, the plan is, from Tilo Tango Alpha Zulu, which is our final fix, I've put in the Tango Alpha Zulu 2 Alpha arrival. I've had to manually input it because it doesn't like it when I pick runway 14, so I've just mirrored it. So you go Tango Alpha Zulu, and then you go on an outbound radial to this fix, which I've created off of Podriga, and then right turn to Olivu, Gossett, back to Tango Alpha Zulu, like so, and then you continue for 3 miles, and then you make a left turn to basically go beat the airport, and then it's all visual from here onto runway 14.
Okay.
If you want to look at the approach, it's chart 7-70, max 185 knots on that turn, which, you know, I would want to be flaps 25 gear down, fully configured by that point, so...
Okay. Apparently they've lost colour on the back camera, Dave.
So, what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to put a...
Sorry, what chart were you looking at?
Chart 7-70.
Okay.
So, I'm just going to... Oops. Put in... Donation!
Woohoo! Yep. Right, let's see if I can rip this.
Woo! Nice.
Yay, like a normal person. No. Uni Chaos... Thank you very much for your £12.16039425636.56.
Thank you very much for that.
Blame Craig Kappa.
Yeah, I know, because you've got to fly the approach, so that's actually probably very valid. Right. So, I've now put a 4 mile range ring around. Now, I would probably like to take controls and come off this point, just to fly the downwind leg and then do the visual, so I'm more comfortable with the controls. Sounds pretty reasonable. I know Peter would probably scream at me for suggesting that, but just so I'm comfortable with the controls, fly this bit, but by all means, you keep it to there. The restriction here is 2,600 for this approach, which I've pre-tuned into the FMC.
Yeah.
So yes, with that in mind, we'll go through Route 2, which is slightly different. So in case ATC don't like the fact that we want to do runway 14, I've put in runway 3-2 as well, which is a little bit simpler. Again, over Tango Alpha Sierra, Tango Alpha Zulu, sorry. We then go to that Podrica point, 228, and then we go round to Olivu, Gossett, then Charlie Lima 3-2, Tango Alpha Zulu, 202, 3-2. We've got all the indications in here.
Okay.
This 1140 is the decision height. So I've got 2040 for the circling 14 my side. In the event that we do get runway 3-2, just remind me that I need to change it to 1140.
Okay.
Other than that, it's all in the box, all as it should be on the chart. The escape is a left turn for runway 3-2, a right turn for runway 14, just to go over the sea.
Yep. Avoiding the terrain.
Yeah. So, I've had a quick gander at... this iPad definitely doesn't like being charged, does it?
No.
at the AGC. Runway length is, it's okay. It's not the worst one we've been to. It's certainly not Queenstown, but it's short. It's 2,500 times 45. So if I get the braking action for, I would like actually flaps 30 as well for this approach.
Okay.
Because I want to be as slow as possible.
Okay.
So,
should we put that in?
One thing I'll just do is just deduct 2 tons off the zero fuel, off the gross weight. Just put 234.6. Just see if it makes any difference. Yes, we lost a knot, so that's 30. Okay, so with flaps 30,
yep.
It's I think a dry runway. Where did I put the weather? Yeah. Yeah, no rain. A recent rain, I'm going to presume it's a dry runway, and it's 2,500. We could take flaps, autobrake 2, no, sorry, we can't take autobrake 2. Autobrakes 3, autobrakes 4, I'm happy with 3. And then we can, I'll call whatever reverse depending on how far I floated down the runway.
Roger.
So that's that done, autobrake 3, and good. So I'll just double check quickly the briefing notes, see if I need anything. We've done pretty much everything. Go around as discussed, right turn 1-4, left turn 3-2, and you climb 2, it's the same on both, 6,000 I think. Yeah, 6,000 okay. On both, so climb 6,000.
Yep, so the MSA is?
MSA is 2,400 to the southwest, 7,400 over the airfield to the north, and 6,300 to the southeast.
Wait. Transition?
Is 10,000. And I have done the wind, so we should get some descent data in a second.
Dixie.
Radio aids, there's not a lot for us to pick, really. We've got a DME off to VAT, which should auto-tune. And the other one it'll probably pick is Podriga. We can actually take 345, which is TAS, in the ADF. And I'll select that. And then actually I'll hard tune 111.3, which is not like it. Why won't it like that? 111.30? Okay, it doesn't like that. Doesn't like the DME, so never mind. We'll just leave it. We've got the ADF in there anyway. Other than that, I think we're pretty good. QNH, if you want to preset it, is 1001. Elevation, it's pretty much at sea level. Just the mountainous terrain. We've got a reset MCP, so I take it we must be rather close to top of descent.
Yep.
10 miles. So, my main question is, have you got any questions? As I said, the key is we find out as early as possible which runway we are going to be given.
Yep.
And then we make the switch to route 2 if they give us, if they make us do 3-2.
Okay.
Any questions, Craig?
Nah.
Wonderful. So would you like a descent checklist?
Okay.
Recall. Actually, you should be doing this to me, I think.
Descent checklist, recall.
Checked.
Autobrake
3.
Landing data
is in.
Approach briefing
completed.
Temp checklist complete.
Cool. So you have control.
I
my
have
radios.
I have control. Your radios. So do you want to request descentage?
Who are we with? Eurocontrol.
I believe so. Yeah, I'm not sure.
Well, no, actually, I think 1358. Someone else. Oh, who knows? Speedbird 47 Charlie is standing by for descent.
Charlie,
second. Speedbird 47 Charlie is standing by for descent.
47 Charlie, descent flight level 250.
Descent flight level 250, Speedbird 47 Charlie.
We'll do that in VNAV, so we'll wait for it to hit.
If you push it now, it'll just drop at 1,000 feet a minute until it captures.
Is it?
Yeah.
Alright, okay.
Should do. Should descend at 1,000 feet until it gets onto profile. So we'll drop below profile.
Yep.
Then as soon as the diamond comes down, we'll catch it.
So Kev32B asks, is your day job, Dave, a controller?
Negative, Kev. No, it's not. I'm in the banking profession. Why did you laugh?
I'm just childish.
What, because I press fuel in ECS?
No. Just whenever you say banking, I have to replace it with another word.
Yeah, because you are immature.
Yes. I'm sorry. Thanks, babe.
Oh, it goes as well. I know your wrist might ache. Christine's been about a lot.
FXception, the camps have been playing out for the last day or so, unfortunately, so they're the best that we can sort of get them at the moment, but after this flight we've got a 3-hour turnaround, so we're going to have a look at the cameras again, just to make sure that they're sort of working okay. Just thought of the W word, Craig. Yes. So
ignore that driving word.
Yeah, no, that's fine. BNF speed. Or I do what Luke does.
I know. Parkin did it earlier again, and I said, did he do it just to wind me up? Okay, I've got Taz identified now. The ABF. For the approach, obviously I'll take terrain my side, if you can have weather please.
Yep. Luke Beans, quite of late in the stream. What does that mean?
Wasn't Luke late yesterday to one of his flights? Is that what Kev's referring to maybe?
I'm not sure.
I put 644 Zulu in there just for 20 minutes before landing, so gives us a reminder for the seatbelt.
Okie dokie. How did you do that anyway?
You go into fix and then bottom right puts the time. Gary took me on.
Oh, being quiet when in stream. Yeah, Luke's generally quite quiet. He's, I don't know, he's not a very
sociable
person.
Although he's got a very deep voice.
Yeah,
a billowing voice.
Yeah. Have you ever met his dad?
Gareth, yeah.
Yeah.
Cameras are glitching because that's what we had our issue last night, which...
I've already explained that, Dave.
Don't know.
It's already explained that, Dave.
So we told them what today's giveaway is later on, or not giveaway, donation.
Is this PSX? No, PSX tomorrow, right? Is today another FS Labs?
It is. Later on today, when Andy turns up, so this evening. Giving away another copy of FS Labs. Kindly been donated.
Okay, happy to put them down. Cabin crew, 20 minutes to landing.
Dark outside because it's absolutely pouring down.
Yeah, it's. I think I'll be going upstairs rather than trying to make it across to the house. Weird that it did that. It floated up over Nera and then put itself above profile.
Yeah.
Who's flying next? I don't know.
Horgy, Simon, and somebody else.
Simon? He's gone to bed.
I think Simon's got this one.
He is gonna.
Oh, I apologise for that.
Well, if you're gonna do it, you should get out.
What are your smells?
Stormfly, good morning. No, it does smell. That's horrendous, actually.
To go.
I'll be upstairs.
I actually can't smell it, which I'm quite grateful for.
Really?
That day's open, that door is probably going to wash straight in my face.
I'll probably follow through as well.
Nice.
Morning, goats.
Clear 47 Charlie, level in 252.
347 Charlie, continue flight level 150.
Send flight level 150, speed 47 Charlie. 150 set.
Smoke in the cockpit. Yep. Wait, we're really trying to land a 747 into that.
Lushan's 86 can do it, we can do it.
Hell yeah. Another challenge.
So that high terrain's quite visible, 5,600 to the west. Or to the east, sorry.
Yes. My terrain on my side.
787, Spear 47 Charlie, thank you, good morning.
Good morning, unprepared flyer.
Morning, Joe. And Centre, good morning, Speedbird 47, Charlie 3, flight number 188, flight number 150, inbound Buchan, requesting R14 if available. Speedbird 47, Charlie, descending 185 to 150, inbound Buchan.
Speedbird 10-4, Charlie, please approach to Morgan.
Okay, right 150. Is there any chance for the 14 approach? Roger, 47 Charlie, right 150. Okay, so route 2.
Stormy Flyer, no, we've just been given the to expect the localizer for runway 32, so. That been executed on mine as well, because mine's.
Shouldn't it duplicate on both sides?
Should do, yeah, that's what I thought.
It might need to go into route 2 now. There you go.
Right.
8001 for Spirit 47 Charlie.
Flight level change then.
Okay. Okay, so I've set 1001 passing 153 now.
And a 5000,
velocity 99.0.
So, as it's runway 32 now, its MDA is 1170.
What's the barrier need to be, sir?
1170. Oh, it's so annoying when it jumps like that, isn't it?
Yeah.
Is Trump one?
I think so, yeah.
Unbelievable.
So we called it, being Brexit, all we needed was Trump to become president, and here we go. Might have to use a little bit of lever of shape.
No, because we're above profile.
Yeah?
Oh, relax, I'll try it. Let's try and avoid using this baby.
Okay.
Because I think he's going to take us way out. We're going to be behind the Qantas 2-5. Andy, runway 32 is that we vacate at the end. Don't have to backtrack.
Okay.
low profile. Okay, approach checklist, altimeters.
1001 passing through 105 now for 8000.
104 for 8000, approach checklist complete.
Tweet.
I threw you off there by not picking up the checklist, didn't I?
Sorry?
I threw you off there by not picking up the checklist.
You did, yeah.
Pass at 10.
Yippee!
Reduce speed 210, so we have 47 Charlie. I'd be inclined to go to 218 and not tell him, just so he can stay flaps out.
Oh yeah, forgot about that.
1860. Base of the clouds 2300 apparently.
Yuck. Elderly racer, crud, is there room in the UK for me?
One to go.
Yep.
1800. Don't see why not, elderly racer, don't see why not. Camera ready.
Okay.
Five 4 7 Charlie. Really doesn't like our call sign, does he?
Nope.
5000 set. Flight level change.
Flight level change.
Crap. I wrote back 5000, I don't know what he's going to make it.
1025 for turn number right, 280. Flat 1, please, Dave.
Not flat 1.
Yes, please.
Should we check flat 1?
We'll do 210 knots as he's asked us.
Okay.
What was that message for, Dave?
No, it's just 5,000 he put in the chat.
Alright.
We didn't read it. To clean up the ND, I'm just going to give us some guzzer. Because I think that's what he'll do.
HZ975 team is wishing us a safe landing.
Thank you very much, HZ975, appreciate that.
Because it's a short runway.
It is.
Care for an auto brake for free?
Left 080 speed, 180 speed before 7 Charlie.
Not going for auto brake for?
1-5,
Flat 5, please, Dave.
That's 5.
1-8-0, good day, cross 2-5. Give it,
Never had Tivit control of that sim. Yeah, it's quite rare. Although it did when they first brought the scene. This is one of the best things about world flight. You go to airports.
Full ATC.
Ever go to, ever again. That is being complete ATC this time as well. So.
I'm ready.
Okay,
my straps.
That's why it's good to actually fly along with World Flight Teams, because it is that only chance of getting this sort of ATC.
Look at these clouds as well.
Look good, don't they?
Epic.
It's on the outside view, so get rid of those lines and put it swapped over.
Strapping in, aye?
Strapping in. Sure fly on the approach. F-3-5-0-4-7-Charlie.
Doesn't like our call sign, does he?
He gets it wrong every time.
Good morning, yeah. Air 4 5.
This is 4-5-3-8-4-8-0-2-1-3-9.
It's worth going for a flight down here, because it is a challenging level.
I wanted 1-4. I was asking for 1-4 and he wouldn't give it to us.
Stormflyer, basically there is a VATSIM, sorry, a World Flight Team. However, if there's local controllers, we will tend to allow them to do it. Unless they get swamped, then we'll actually help them out.
On this heading, cleared for the localizer approach, runway 32247 Charlie.
I'll just go direct Gossett, to be honest. The race didn't actually take us long to catch up, because we're,
my opinion,
quite fast.
Is that on the localizer, is it?
Yeah.
Is that on the beacon?
Yep.
Or just heading it round,
yeah,
then, or something?
Just headed to Gossa, and then if we just do that, go to LNAV. Go LNAV, ENAV now, we've got all the descents in there.
We'll just intervene the speed.
Oh, yeah.
So. Sorry, I just wanted to get it down before it spooled right up again.
Yep. We never skip legs, Daffis. Just the fact that we're quite good at doing quick change around or turnarounds these days, because we have multiple crews, so the next crew is already planned as they can come in. Anti-faff, get clearance, taxi. And then we just, because we've got so much fuel, because you've been so generous with your donations, we can actually afford to dump all our fuel and have a complete empty aircraft. Not so much short of changeover, it's just the fact that we're efficient, as I'm saying.
We are
using German efficiency, but as British people. And that's one benefit of having four engines, you can go a bit faster.
So we can descend on this procedure as well, can't we?
Yep.
So, we can descend down to 2,600 by TAS.
Yep.
One 60 knots and 1180. Speedbird 47 Charlie. Thank you. Good afternoon. Sorry. Good morning.
Flap 10, please.
Flaps 10.
Tivat Tower, good morning to you, Spirit 47 Charlie, on the localizer approach for runway 32.
Spirit 47 Charlie, Tivat Tower, good morning. Continue approach number 3, sequence maintained 180 knots. So direct Tango Alpha Zulu, descend 2500, report
reaching Tango Alpha Zulu. Okay, just for information, we've already been given 160 by Tower, so we'd like to maintain that, please, and we will report overhead Tango Alpha Zulu, Spirit 47 Charlie.
Spirit 47 Charlie, can you give me 180 or do you prefer 180?
I would prefer to keep 160 now, please, Spirit 47 Charlie.
47 Charlie, thank you.
BS, yeah?
It should go into VNAV to send.
Did it? Okay.
I'll let the profile start.
Oh, yeah.
You just we'll double check it and just have your finger ready to push the button. I don't think you need to, I think you should capture it.
Coming up, so.
Should capture it. And we'll just touch off the localizer. Appeared now.
I actually want to press the localizer button.
Sorry?
I
not going to press the level.
Oh yeah, we can. Yeah.
We can do now. We've got it. but the thing is, you can run it off LNAV-VNAV as well. LNAV-VNAV is probably better because we've got the descent path in there.
Brothers 25,
Trinity
1001, what's your altitude?
The orbital. The only thing is we have captured the localizer.
Right, push down.
Current altitude,
VNAV speed. Okay, good.
Okay.
So remember, we won't. This is not a glide slope. This is just a localizer. Yeah.
Yep.
So, although we're a touch left, we're pretty much on the path that we should be according to the FMC.
Yep.
Tumbler pilot, good morning.
It's kind of like flying an RNAV, but not.
Stormflyer, there may only be 7 parking slots for real. However, we have the magical world-like grass parking slots and taxiways available to us at all times.
Awesome scenery down here.
Craig and Dave doing a tough approach. Let's see how this goes. I think it'd be quite good, actually. We're getting quite good at these. Hopefully. I had to do a go-around last night.
Did?
Yeah.
Where was that?
To where?
Gatwick, Tenerife.
That's where we have slight issues. Because we said we're going to do the giveaway.
Okay, that's localizer established.
Gary, maybe.
I'll probably cycle that down to MDA 1100.
1100, well, at TAS we need to be at 2600.
Oh, okay,
so
yeah, that's a good point. Actually, it's dropped below profile, so why it's done now, I'm not quite sure, but
yeah, so
we can monitor.
Well,
it.
We'll level off at 2600,
yeah, I agree.
And then we'll get to TAS.
Okay. Yeah. Don't know why it dropped us down so early, but that might be okay.
Yeah.
Never forget about the grass. Park them on the grass.
Velocity 99901, can you use the stance further to the south? Because we need a heavy stance for the jumbo jet engine.
Oh, the velocity doesn't want to do that. He's completely ignoring him. He might already be there. We'll park on top of him.
Yeah.
Just remember not to block the motorway that runs alongside.
Yeah, there's a road right at the end of the runway, isn't there? Yeah.
This is always what amuses me when you see this. You've got like a hut on a single runway with about 50 aircraft.
And the thing is, there's a tree on the final, because when I tested this scenery, there's trees all on the final for a 3-2.
I've never been in here before.
It's tight.
Oh, she just got in the AFCAD and moved it.
Sorry?
Got in the AFCAD and moved it.
Deleted it, yeah, deleted the trees out. Yeah. It's nice scenery this time.
It is a good approach.
Yeah, it's quite challenging with the high terrain and stuff, isn't it?
It reminds me a bit like going to Madeira and going the other way.
Yeah. I'll probably take over at 1200 just before MDA.
Okay.
If that's okay by you.
What I'll do, because I'm not trusting the VNAV, I'll VSC.
Yeah, absolutely fine. Happy with that.
So it's TIV is at 7.3 on the DME, so
yeah.
I'll wind this down to, what do you say, 1100?
Yeah.
Okay.
247 Charlie overhead, Tango Alpha Zulu.
247 Charlie, have you cleared to land? No, I should disregard, continue approach number 2 and landing clearance in very few moments.
No problems, continue, get that Qantas off the runway, 247 Charlie.
What did you do at 2,500 feet?
Check.
Meter checks.
So again,
altimeter checks 2,500.
Yeah,
yep. Passing 2,300
and on visual.
On 1001. You want to put the gear down as well, please, Dave?
Gear down.
Flap 20.
Flaps 20. Glad to see those Aussies got out of the way. Cleared land to runway 3-2, Spirit 4-7 Charlie. Was it challenging, Qantas?
Say again, sorry?
I was asking the other aircraft if it was challenging.
Say the last part. I'll do whatever.
Flap 30.
Charlie, arrange your landing to vacate at Ian to the right via taxiway Alpha, which is broad to wider and easy for you to exit the divided passage.
Okay, we'll vacate at the end, 47 Charlie.
And to the right.
If we vacate to the left, it's probably right. We're a bit higher. Comes the Pappies.
Okay, landing checklist.
Okay.
Speed
brake
is armed.
Landing gear
is down.
Laps
30.
Cabin port
is received.
Okay, as we're high.
Yep.
I have control visual.
You have control.
Brecky man, good morning.
Good time to arrive.
Speed at VRF. Watch the speed.
Yep.
Waypoint.
50
above.
Decide. Continue.
Okay.
And now
my
502 high speed is appreciated because we have a.
Oh no! I just seen ballsed up, hasn't it?
It's Vector.
Yeah.
Ah, well, we'll see.
Yeah, we'll have to do it anyway, won't we?
Oh, we got bushes. Ready to get out the grass cutters. Grass cutters. It's gonna be interesting.
Yeah.
And
I just
want to double check where you cleared the localizer by approach, or how was it?
Yeah.
Slightly high.
I just don't want this FCAD to be off. And we land above what we should be.
Gonna be positive. Sure, you don't want auto brake for?
Yep.
What the scenery was tested?
It was tested, it was fine when I left it. Thought the scenery was tested, screw you.
Poor reverse, yeah?
Yep. Poor reverse.
Cubes, no, they wouldn't let us have the NDB. Unfortunately. Freeze buildings.
Versus normal, speed break. Yes. Up.
Okay, forward idle.
Forward idle.
Sorry about the scenery, guys. It's probably my fault. Brakes released. Okay, we're on to the end.
Okie dokie.
Score? 0.
Ah.
Oh, obviously.
Good morning, Mr. 400 localizer 3.
Out by 3. You're getting quite good at this, Skyways.
58, Zero Tower, good morning. Continue approach number 3.
If we can get the vector bit done before take off.
Yeah, we will, yeah.
347 Charlie Heavy. So let's get to the right via Alpha, taxi to the apron, standard for choice, and welcome to you.
Apron standard of choice, speedway 47 Charlie, cheers.
Tower right, 502 Settle and runway 32, when is time?
I'll wait here to Jim runway 32, we'll have a go, Paris 02. Okay, flaps 15.
Base bar, Kev.
Okay, APU please.
Apoo!
CJ 458, maintain high speed until Tango Alpha Zulu reports Tango Alpha Zulu.
Reef there, 458, maintain high speed.
I'm just going to take the stand on the left.
Okay.
Put it nose out for the next crew.
Coming crew, doors to manual, cross check please.
Yeah, nightbot's a bit weird.
What was the touchdown rate out of interest, Dave?
364.
That's right.
Not too bad.
Issue is the trees. Wait, I'm not stand. Wait.
Come on, mate!
I just realised I think only one of the brakes are mapped. Okay.
Okay, shut down please, Craig.
Shut down.
Doing a full shutdown because of the
secure. Yeah, we'll secure it.
We do go on.
Yeah, we can go on.
You get 458 confirm that you're on the approach because you're offset and just close to the terrain.
I'll take the other one.
I don't know why it came off both gens.
I don't know why it came off that the other gen.
Yeah.
Before.
Yeah, for facade approach visually, remember it's an offset approach for Kiva, not straight in, so you are
okay.
Flying.
Okay. Ah, now the other one's gone. Okay, shut down checklist, please.
Shut down checklist.
Yeah, 458,
speed brake? No. That's after landing checklist. Sorry. I've done that. Shut down checklist. Parking brake?
Is set.
Hydraulic demand pumps?
Are off.
Fuel pumps?
Are off.
Beacon?
Off.
Doors?
Manual.
Oh, we got a donation there.
Yeah, the manual.
Fuel control switches?
Cut off.
Transponder?
Off.
Seatbelt signs?
Off.
ACARS post flight? Haven't done.
Oops.
I'm going to 502 field deck vessel has issue coming in. T-Watt taxi to the air.
So we have two donations to read out. The first one is... Actually, I don't know which order they come in, actually. So, Stormy, thank you very much for your £3 donation. Great stuff. And the second donation is from Nelson WTP. Thank you very much for your £10 donation.
Nelson, thank you very much for those donations. Very kind of you both. Thank you very much for that. Okay, so we can secure the aircraft as the other crew that's at aft cargo door opening. So we can get rid of the IRSs.
Yep.
IRSs are gone, just get rid of your terrain. Other than that, I don't think we can lose the APU now. All the other things are good on there. Turn off that one and we'll just leave that one normal. So, the securing checklist, please.
Okay, secure checklist.
Yep.
Yep, IRS mode selectors.
Are off.
Emergency lights.
Are now off.
Aft cargo heat.
Off.
Packs.
Off. Except one, which we're keeping on for ventilation.
Yeah, external power
is selected.
APU
is off.
Standby power switch
is now off.
Battery switch
is now off.
Flight deck access switch.
Flight deck access switch is down here, I think, isn't it? It should be unlocked, but it's locked in auto.
Okay, secure checklist complete.
And that's the aircraft secure, guys. So. We are going to have to do some maintenance during this turnaround. We are on the ground in Tivat for 3 hours. We managed to catch up about, we've landed 10 minutes late, so I'm going to try and fix this scenery, job one. Fix the cameras. Why the scenery was wrong, I'm not quite sure, because it was fine when we tested it, so that's obviously something gone wrong.
So the stream might go down, guys, but we'll be back at 10 o'clock departure, I believe. So
if you haven't hit that follow button,
yep.
Hit it now, because you'll get an alert when we come online. Make sure you've got notifications turned on. And the next sector is here to Istanbul.
Okay. See you guys then.
Have a good one, guys.
See ya.
Bye-bye.
Bye.